Hey, Charles! Charles! What you doing way out here? Oh, no, that's not Charles. Wait, that might be Charles.
Judge.
That bet not be you, nigga. I'ma call your ass later. You're from the lower ghetto to the higher ghetto. They act like they don't know your ass, you know what I'm saying?
What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Mark Dark, and I'm back with another Insecure video. If you're new, if you love Insecure, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, like the video, and leave your theories, comments, everything down below. Now, today we're going to go over Insecure Season 4, Episode 6. This is the recap, and this episode was funny as hell. I didn't think this episode was going to be all that, but it surprised me, man. This shit was so funny. We need to get your boy George on this show. He has to be a regular, in my opinion, man. Dude had me cracking up. Now, I'm going to go over just the key points, just a quick recap of what happened in last night's episode. If you think I missed anything, leave it down below. Let me know what you think. Now, the episode begins with your girl Issa, and it's the night or the day after the block party. And Issa is in her feelings, man. She doesn't like what happened between her and Molly. It's quite obvious. She's getting calls from Amal and also Kelly on, is she okay? I mean, that was a huge outburst between the two. And we knew it was coming. We knew the two would eventually get into it. But Issa, she's just trying to have a cool day. Of course, Kelly wants her to call Molly. And Issa, she's just like, look, I'm cool. And she even convinces herself, like, look, I normally do this. Because in the past, Issa probably would have called Molly first and tried to handle this. But now she's like, look, I always call her first. I'm not about to be the one that calls her now. And that's exactly what she does the whole episode. She's like, look, I'm going to live my life. If she want to call me and settle this, that's on her. That's something that maybe Molly should do. Now, what do you guys think? Do you think Issa should have called her, or Molly should have called Issa? Now, Issa, she has to do something to take her mind off the whole situation. So she's going around overly cleaning the house and the refrigerator, going crazy pretty much. The girl had me cracking up. Now, she talks to Nathan, and he pretty much tells her she did good at the event. Don't worry about nothing. It's not really her fault or whatever. She should be proud of herself. And he's right. You know, she should be proud of herself. She still threw a very good event. And besides the whole outlash between her and Molly, I think everything was cool. We don't really see too much more of Nathan at all in this episode. We just see him at the very beginning. Then after that, that's it. Now, in this episode, Issa, she's dealing with a lot of random people. And first off, we get this girl right here who Issa was about to pay for her stuff. And we find out that it was over $140. But Issa's card was not working. And then the old girl, she started tripping out. Like, okay, I don't really need it. It was a lot of randoms in this episode. A lot of random people. But the funniest one of them all was your boy, George. This dude right here, he needs to just be a regular on the show. This dude had me cracking up. I mean, he is funny as hell. Please bring him back to the show. I mean, dude was just, he was wild. Now, Issa offers to take him where he needed to be taken to. She was being nice. She doesn't even know this dude. But this dude was tweaking out. He was having to go to the bathroom. He was hollering out the window. He kept saying the N-word over and over. He was cussing. Had me cracking up. And for a moment, Issa was about to leave his ass, but she didn't. And it seems like George ended up finding his son after I don't know how many years. But that dude is definitely funny as hell. I wish he would be in the show regularly. Now we get your girl, Kyla Pratt. Yes, she's here. And we already know something is up. You know what I'm saying? Something is up with these people, because we get the first girl at the store. We get George. Now we get these girls right here. I think Issa's like, she's at like a paint and sip event. She doesn't know these girls at all. Everything seems cool. Issa is pretty much telling them about her life, about what she does and everything like that. I'm like, okay, they do seem kind of, they kind of seem cool, but you know something is up, right? Then Issa comes back out of the restroom and she sees that these girls play her. You know what I'm saying? Pretty much befriend a stranger, leave them. I mean, they play your girl Issa. And for a moment, I thought this vision that Issa had, I thought this was actually the reality. And I was hoping it was, because this shit was funny. Issa popped up out of nowhere, found the girls. They end up dipping out, trying to make Issa pay for all that food. And, you know, Issa pops up on them and goes off, y'all. This shit, once again, funny as hell. Caught me off guard. I'm like, okay, this episode is definitely, I will say, this was the funniest episode so far this season, in my opinion. Now, Issa, of course, she goes, she talks to her mother. And you know how parents do. They try to just calm you down, tell you everything's going to be all right. And that's pretty much what her mom tells Issa. Now, Issa also talks to your girl Kelly one more time. And Kelly's like, look, did you talk to Molly yet? Are y'all going to squash this? You know, I'm going to call her too. Issa, she doesn't want to do it. She feels like Molly should be the one to call her. I don't know how long they're going to stretch this out, but eventually the two will have that conversation. As I told you guys in my prior videos, they will definitely have this conversation on who was right, who was wrong, and if they can possibly come back together. But as of right now, it ain't looking too good for them. Now, Issa, at the very end of the episode, she does see Molly inside of this bar or whatever. And for a split second, she thought about going in there. Now, old Issa from the prior seasons probably would have went in there and tried to just, you know, squash all this, you know, fusion between the two. You know, so this drama. But she didn't do it. She didn't do it. She said, you know what? I'm good. I'm walking off. I'm driving off. And that's exactly what your girl Issa did. You guys let me know, man. This overall, this was a solid-ass episode. I was not expecting this episode to be so funny. Definitely one of the funniest episodes I've seen this season. The funniest episode I've seen this season. That George character, man. Dude had me cracking up. Straight up. He had me cracking up. I really wish we can get him back in the show somehow, some way, because he's hilarious. But overall, solid episode. What do you guys think? Leave your theories, predictions, everything down below. Let me know, what do you see happening next? I think next week we're going to be getting Molly's episode. She's going to be with Andrew. I think they're going to Mexico or something like that. So we're going to see how her episode is and if she's going to make that decision to, you know, to talk to Issa first. But keep supporting your boy, and I will continue to bring you more Insecure content in the future. But it's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.